Well, here it is, the Easter egg apocalypse. Steven Spielberg's adaptation of Ready Player One was always going to be chock full of cameo appearances and references to our favorite pop culture properties, but wow, did we underestimate just how many there would be. We may not have Halliday's keys or an Oasis visor, but we're still going to do our very best to show you just how many Easter eggs there are in this movie. Well, besides that one. Spoilers ahead! The opening sequence shows us multiple planets in the Oasis, including Minecraft World. One of them is Ludus, which is an important original planet from the novel. You can also see Batman helping climbers ascend Mount Everest in this scene. During the Anorak's invitation video, Oasis creator James Halliday wears a Simon button on his jacket. Halliday's stage funeral is Star Trek themed, with a giant Starfleet logo visible on the wall. You can see numerous characters outside of Halliday's journal library, including Reaper and Tracer from Overwatch, Hello Kitty, Bets Maru, Carapie, RoboCop, and Doc Brown from Back to the Future Part 2. Inside the library, Beetlejuice and Lara Croft greet Parzival as fans. Artemis gives Parzival Christopher Reeve's Clark Kent disguise so he can continue his studies uninterrupted. There's a Tempest machine in the library, which prominently features in the book's third challenge. Castle Anorak is on Planet Doom, a planet from Voltron. Gunters come here to grind experience points by fighting high-level opponents. We see ostriches from the 1982 arcade game Joust used as steeds here. When the ostriches are killed, they turn into eggs, just like in the game. H uses the assault rifle from Halo to mow down Duke Nukem and Freddy Krueger, who's not the only horror icon visible. You can also see Jason Voorhees. The Copper Key race may take place in Delta City from RoboCop, but at the very least, there's a poster for the movie City on a building. We see a number of familiar faces at the starting line, including Ryu from Street Fighter, Dizzy from Gears of War, and Lara Croft, not to mention some iconic rides like the Plymouth Fury from Stephen King's Christine, the A-Team's van, Speed Racer's Mach 5, the 1966 Batmobile, and the Interceptor from Mad Max. The main characters are racing in style as well. Parzival drives the DeLorean from Back to the Future, which is modified with kit lights from Knight Rider. The dates and the time circuits are accurate to the movie. Parzival wears a Thundercats belt buckle. H drives the Bigfoot monster truck. Artemis rides Kaneda's bike from Akira, which is plastered with Atari, Taito, Sega, and Hello Kitty stickers. During the race, drivers are attacked by King Kong and Rexy from Jurassic Park. When Parzival wins a race, Anorak says "nice racing, Padawan" to him. After Parzival wins a Copper Key race and goes shopping with his winnings, we see stores selling merch from Street Fighter, Overwatch, Halo, Borderlands, and Dungeons & Dragons. Parzival buys a Rubik's Cube called a Zemeckis Cube, an artifact capable of reversing time by 1 minute. Robert Zemeckis, of course, directed Back to the Future. He also buys the Holy Hand Grenade of Antioch from Monty Python and the Holy Grail. In the real world, Samantha wears a Joy Division shirt. She and Wade are investigating a number of movies that may hint at how to acquire the Crystal Key, including Gremlins, The Dark Crystal, Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom, Krull, Splash, and the Helm's Deep scene from Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. The Sixers are keeping track of strongholds where the Crystal Key could be hidden on a whiteboard. Isengard of Lord of the Rings is crossed off. Helen, H in the Oasis, mentions she's just practicing her Mario Kart as IOI chases them. Toshiro, Dido in the Oasis, has a Mortal Kombat sticker on his Oasis gear. Wade refers to Ogden Morrow as Halliday's Rosebud, a reference to the lost sled from Citizen Kane. And there's an R2-D2 visible in Wade and Samantha's apartment. Halliday wears a Space Invaders shirt in a flashback, and there's a Galaga poster behind him during the scene where he mentions wanting to take the Oasis backwards, saying, "That's what Bill and Ted did." In another flashback, Halliday talks about taking a woman named Kira on a date. Her real name is Karen, but she goes by Kira because she loves the similarly named character from The Dark Crystal. You can also see a Billy Idol album during that scene as well. H is working on fixing someone's Battlestar Galactica, and you can also see ships from Alien and Silent Running. We also see H's in-progress build of the Iron Giant, which she ends up using in the final battle. Parzival and Artemis quiz each other on Halliday's favorite shooter, GoldenEye. His favorite mode was Slappers Only, and his favorite character was Oddjob. Noob. Parzival mentions he watches Artemis's Twitch streams. H's room is decorated with Space Invaders decals and posters for Beastmaster, The Fly, and Raiders of the Lost Ark. You can also see a Save Ferris t-shirt in there as well. There's also a hoverboard and Goldie Wilson campaign poster from Back to the Future. Parzival's outfit options for his date with Artemis include Michael Jackson's Thriller costume, Prince's outfit from Purple Rain, and a Duran Duran inspired look. He settles on Peter Royal's outfit from Buckaroo Banzai Across the 8th Dimension. During the party at the Distracted Globe, you can see some prominent guests including Blanca, Harley Quinn and the Joker, Gandalf, and Deathstroke. There's also a bartender wearing the flower pot hat made famous by 80s synth band Devo. While Sorrento is trying to convince Parzival to join IOI, he tempts him with the idea that he could get a Millennium Falcon, a very rare ship in the Oasis. Sorrento pretends to know 80s pop culture, referencing Ferris Bueller's Day Off, The Breakfast Club, Tab, Duran Duran, and Robotron. The Jade Key Challenge takes place in a beautiful recreation of The Shining's Overlook Hotel. Iconic Shining references here include Jack Torrance's All Work and No Play pages with the text in the shape of a key, Room 237 and the creepy bathtub lady inside, the Grady twins, the bloody elevator doors, a chase through the Overlook's hedge maze, the photo from the end of the movie with Halliday in the foreground instead of Jack Torrance, Danny's tricycle is also visible at one point. The ghosts dancing in the hotel's gold room also seem like an homage to the Haunted Mansion at Disneyland. Before the final battle outside of Castle Anorak, Parzival broadcasts a message to all Oasis users with a camera that looks like a magic 8-ball. Dido arrives to the battle in a Firefly-class ship. Shiny! Parzival rallies the crowd with a Say Anything-style boombox raise, except instead of Peter Gabriel's In Your Eyes, the song playing is Twisted Sister's We're Not Gonna Take It. I-Rock mentions the classic Tootsie Pop Owl commercial during a conversation with Sorrento. Arrakis and Harkonnen dropships from Dune are mentioned before the fight. The third challenge is finding the very first video game Easter egg in the 1980 Atari game, Adventure. The final battle is the most Easter egg-heavy scene in the entire movie. Cameos here include Battletoads, Sabat, Deadshot, Catwoman, Lara Croft, Cassie Cage, Tracer, Chun-Li, Spartans from Halo, the RX-78-2 Gundam from Mobile Suit Gundam, Chucky, Red Lion from Voltron, the Cyclops from the Seventh Voyage of Sinbad, Sub-Zero, Raiden, Sonic the Hedgehog, Blanka, Batgirl, Jason Voorhees, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Big Daddy from Bioshock, and He-Man. Parzival uses a rocket launcher from Halo. Artemis uses a lancer from Gears of War. This one fires lasers instead of bullets. She also uses a Mad Balls grenade to destroy Sorrento's Mecha Godzilla. Parzival performs a Hadouken from Street Fighter against Sorrento during their fight. The Iron Giant dies in a river of lava, but not before giving us a Terminator 2-inspired thumbs up. Halliday's Easter egg is surrounded by statues of Mortal Kombat's Raiden, Sub-Zero, Scorpion, and of course, the dragon from the Mortal Kombat logo. Halliday's bedroom is, naturally, full of nods to his favorite franchises and toys. You can see Marvin the Martian, a King Kong statue, an Etch-a-Sketch, viewfinder sliders. Halliday also has posters for Joust, The Legend of Zelda, and Rush's 2112 album, which plays a big part in the book's third challenge. Helen wears a 2112 shirt in the real world as well. Halliday leaves Parzival with a quote from Groucho Marx saying, "I'm not crazy about reality, but it's still the only place to get a decent meal." And ironically, it's also the only place you can find Easter eggs from Ready Player One. That's everything we spotted, but we know there's more. Let us know what you saw in the comments, and for more on Ready Player One, check out our review as well as our breakdown of the 5 biggest changes the movie made to the novel. And don't forget to like and subscribe to IGN everywhere you like to watch.